वेलकम अगेन फॉर आवर सेकेंड ज्योग्राफी क्लास। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड वेरियस फैक्टर्स विच अफेक्ट द क्लाइमेट ऑफ इंडिया लाइक हिमालयस, ऑल्टीट्यूड, लैटिट्यूड। टुडे वी विल स्टडी द रिमेनिंग फैक्टर्स। Distance from the sea. Sea exerts a moderating influence on the climate as water has a high specific heat capacity, so it takes time to get heated or cool down. Due to land and sea breeze, the places near the sea like Mumbai, Panaji, Chennai, Kolkata, all these places experiences maritime climatic conditions throughout the year. So there is no clear-cut winter season, whereas the places like Chandigarh, Delhi, Jaipur, Lucknow, Patna, etc., situated in the interior parts of the country and away from the moderating influence of land and sea breeze, experience continental climate, that is very hot in summers and very cold in winters. As you can see in the picture that Delhi has extreme winter season and minimum temperature is less than 15 degrees Celsius, whereas Mumbai temperature is between 30 to 35 degrees Celsius. Next factor is jet streams. What are jet streams? These are the air currents that develop in the upper layer of the atmosphere at the tropopause, blowing from westerly direction. Their speed varies from 110 km per hour in summer to about 180 km per hour in winter. These air currents determine the arrival and departure of monsoon winds. Jet streams are divided into two parts, easterly and westerly jet streams. Jet stream blow west to east all across the globe when warm air masses meets cold air masses in the atmosphere. Air masses have different temperature because the sun does not heat the earth evenly. Areas near the equator are hot, poles are cold. Warm air rises up in the atmosphere. Polar air sinks down to replace it. This movement causes polar and subtropical jet streams. Subtropical jet streams divides into two parts, easterly and westerly jet streams. Easterly jet streams causes tropical cyclones in India, whereas the westerly jet streams causes temperate cyclones in India. These westerly depressions originate in the Mediterranean Sea and are taken away by the jet stream to eastward after crossing Iraq, Afghanistan, Pakistan. They enter the Indian subcontinent. These depressions are obstructed by the Himalayas, bringing rainfall in Punjab, Haryana, and snowfall in Jammu Kashmir. These depressions are also known by the name temperate cyclones as they originate in the temperate zone between 27 degree north to 50 degree north latitude. As I have already explained that easterly jet streams are responsible for tropical cyclones in India. During October and November, due to difference in temperature and pressure between land and sea, whenever they occur, they cause great loss of life and property due to heavy rain on the eastern coastal regions of India. Next, we will talk about monsoon phenomena and its mechanism. In spite of great diversity and variations in Indian climate and topography, due to the various reasons stated earlier, the most important factor that lend unity to the Indian subcontinent is monsoon. The word monsoon owes its origin to an Arabic word mosam, meaning season. These are periodic seasonal winds developed due to the differential heating as well as cooling of the land and sea. They are divided into two wind system, the summer monsoon and the winter monsoon. India's tapering peninsular topography, surrounded on three sides by water, plays an important role in determining the course of monsoon winds, resulting in unique climate of India. Consisting of four seasons, number one, hot and dry summer from March to May, the rainy season June to September, the retreating monsoon October to November, and cold and dry season December to February. First, we will talk about hot and dry summer season. The vertical rays of the sun falls directly over Tropic of Cancer during March to May, so the length of the day increases. It results in the increase in the solar radiation and the temperatures start rising in the interior parts of the country from 30 to 32 degrees Celsius. In the northwestern parts of India, temperature ranges between 48 to 50 degrees Celsius, but in the southern India, the hot weather is not intense due to the moderating influence of sea, as well as hills are also relatively cool because of high elevation. Next, we will be talking about pressure conditions. Pressure is inversely proportional to temperature. Temperature increases, pressure decreases. As the whole country simmers in heat, low pressure conditions over land becomes more intense in the Thar Desert and Chota Nagpur Plateau region. This gave rise to thunderstorms with hot, dry, dusty winds called Lu, which blow during daytime over northern plains and northwest India. As the sun apparently moves northward direction, due to this movement, temperature rises at a particular place which is called local heating, which causes conventional rising of air, thereby causing thunderstorms, is called pre-monsoon showers. This occurs before monsoon season. That is the reason they are known by the name pre-monsoon showers. This pre-monsoon shower is very much beneficial for different crops in different areas, and they have given a local names in different areas. Like number one, I'll be talking about Kal Baisakhi. What does the word Kal Baisakhi means? Kal means calamity, Baisakhi in the month of Baisakh. They are also known by the name Norwesters, as these winds originate over Chota Nagpur Plateau and are carried eastward by westerlies winds, causes heavy rainfall in West Bengal and Assam. In Assam, it is locally known as Bardoli Chera. This rainfall is quite beneficial for growing jute and rice in West Bengal and tea in Assam. Next, we'll be talking about mango showers. This is a pre-monsoon showers along the Kerala coast, is important for mango and tea cultivation. They are also known as cherry blossom, as it is good for the cultivation of coffee and cherry. Let's recapitulate what we have done today. The remaining factors which affect the climate of India, like distance from the sea, jet streams, western disturbances, tropical cyclones, monsoon phenomena, hot and dry season with pre-monsoon showers. Thank you and have a good day.